everything that is said from the perspective of the American Indian movement from the indigenous community has a spiritual content. I am not the person to address that in a direct fashion. I'm a political speaker. I'm a political being. Everything I do is political. There's the emphasis. And so where we go with that, and UAP Newton is a definition of politics, and it's a definition I think we can all relate to, because in order to be politically inclined, we must first understand the nature of political consciousness. And politics, Huey said, was the ability to define a phenomena and then cause it to act in a desired manner. Simple as that. It's an exercise in power, but first and foremost, you have to be able to define the phenomena you wish to address and cause to act in desired manner. Without the definition, without the understanding, without the clarity of what it is we're about, we can accomplish nothing constructive other than by happenstance. And anarchists or no, we are not disorganized happenstance individuals. We have goals we wish to meet. We have objectives we wish to meet. It's not simply a matter of intuition. It's not simply a matter of emotion, although intuition and emotion are both important. We demand, first of all, clarity. We've got a lot of power that's on the street. You see that power at the WTO. You saw that power in Eugene. You saw that power in Quebec. You see that power happening now in Sweden. I'm almost inclined to believe that the consciousness of the people, by and large, most charged up with trying to accomplish some sort of constructive change in the face of the WTO, in the face of globalization, in the face of all these things, is that the process at issue is something that originated in speech delivered by George Herbert Walker Bush somewhere around 1990 or 91. Not so. Globalization, corporatization, the whole process that we're up against here has a rather greater longevity than that. Now we could go to peeling the onion in a Foucauldian manner, following Nietzsche. We're going to be all intellectual now. We're going to go back. Well, the precursor to the WTO, of course, was the Trilateral Commission, and before that was classical colonial impositions by the empires of Europe and various quarters of the world, encompassing 85% of the planetary surface, and blah, 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 blah. And before that, and before that, and before that. Well, we can go, as Chellis said, back 10,000 years in peeling the onion. We can look for the origin there. I think you can probably find the origin conceptually of the process we're up against truly thousands of years ago on the first page of Genesis. You can start to understand it in the separation of man from nature, and that's the terminology used. The postulation that man is the signification, the personification, if you will, of God in the worldly dimension, not only apart from nature, but standing above nature, demonstrating this separateness and this supremacy, this superiority, this overarching entitlement by way of exercising dominion over nature, as will be signified by ultimately multiplying, growing plentiful, and populating the earth, a process which can only occur by way of displacing every other species, every other relation in the environment, and that being not only a goal, a noble objective to be pursued, but ultimately a divine enjoinder. The Europeans were synthesized out of a multiplicity of indigenous peoples with relations to the land not dissimilar for those encountered among indigenous peoples here at one time until the Holy Roman Empire was constituted by force of arms, compelling them to change their belief systems, their languages, and so forth, be re-engineered into something called Europe, which is an old Greek term meaning darkness and ignorance, appropriated as a signifier of triumphalism, and having accomplished that internal colonization, then projected the same order or disorder, as you will, outwards upon the planet. See, that part of European history, which didn't originate with the Greeks, there's 800 odd years of disjunction between the Greeks and the Holy Roman Empire. You got a falsification of history occurring right there. That aspect of what's called European history has been so thoroughly forgotten that there are very few Europeans aware of the fact that they are indeed themselves colonized people. The colonization of Europe in order to create Europe itself has been forgotten, and I would submit to you that it is impossible to be so colonized or any more colonized than to be so colonized as to have forgotten the fact of your colonization. Decolonization has to begin in a mental process of cognition. If you don't know you're colonized, you can hardly be about the process of decolonization. But in any event, following that, you've got a period of internal consolidation that begins to manifest what we are now up against in concrete terms along about 1450 with the attempts by the Portuguese to circumnavigate Africa to open a sea route to what they called the Orient at the time. They never made it during that period, but what they did find was something of value on the coast, and that was human flesh in the form of chattel. You got the advent of the African slave trade, and you got corporate licenses to begin to be issued at that time by the crowns of the incipient state of Spain in order to fuel an economy to make Spain essentially an ascendant power in the newly founded European reality. And you right there have this kind of confluence, interactivity, symbiotic relationship between a corporate entity on the one hand and a state entity on the other hand that is defining the process that we're up against today. If you want to understand globalization, you have to understand European expansion in the form of the outward Iberian projections into Africa and ultimately in 1492 into the so-called New World. You have to understand the dominion that is asserted over chunks of territory and peoples that had never encountered Europe before. You have to understand the appropriation of resources that came with that dominion and the development of the ability to project power in unprecedented fashion. It had never occurred before. It was not a factor in classical imperialism. This is a whole new form of imperialism and a projection of a particular set of relations, an order of understanding, an order of value and priority outward onto the planet in a form that had never occurred before. And it begins then. So the conquest of America, as Todorov called it, coincides essentially with the advent of the process of corporate globalization that has reached a particularly pronounced state of existence today. The nature of the beast that we confront today is the nature of the beast that native peoples have been confronting since a lost Italian seaman washed up on a beach in the Caribbean, half a world away from where he thought he was on the 12th of October, 1492, and got called the Great Navigator ever since.